Oh, that's right. Tell him the story, Fred.
Yeah, because you never heard of a boy. When I was growing up, I knew this chick named Crystal Logie. Her father was a priest, and her brother was my friend, and I used to sleep over there. Oh, and she was fucking hot. And I was like 8. And just understand, oh, hey, what's that? And, hey, you sleep over there and have to get up on Sunday morning to go to Sunday school and get up and go down to the breakfast table at the Logie residence, and Reverend Logie would be reading a Penthouse magazine, drinking vodka, eating eggs. And go to Sunday school and then fuck off on dirt bikes for the rest of the day. Kevin and I went over there with Bobby Williams one day, another friend, and we went up the stairs, and it was the bathroom at the top, Kevin's room, and Krista's room. And Krista come out of the bathroom wearing nothing but a pair of latex zipper front, sort of like Sticky Fingers, Rolling Stones panties.
Yeah.
And went, ugh, like my new panties, boys. And we were like 8. We were like, yeah, something's happening. And she was all fucked up. She was dating this loser named Nibby, who was in a fucking Steely Dan cover band. And he was a jackass. Even when I was 8, I knew he was a jackass. But my friend Ben, I'll make this a long story short. My friend Ben Curtis, who looked like Jim Morrison in our town anyway, and had a Triumph chopper, loved her to death and finally got her. And one day they were riding around on a motorcycle and someone blew a stop sign and they fucking T-boned the car and it fucked them both up really bad. She broke her back. And they put him in the ambulance together and taken him to UMass and she dumped him. Wasn't his fault. In the ambulance. And he never really recovered, so I wrote this song. It's called Chopper.
Chopper.